Hello, my name is Anthony Hall, and in this tutorial we're just going to have a quick look at the smoothing groups in Lightwave 2020. So I've got these two basic shapes, just a ball and a column. All else I need is just go to the more, so the more window, and then smoothing groups, and you get the smoothing groups window. So if I just bring up my surface editor, currently these objects are all assigned to this one surface, and they're all sharing the same smoothing threshold. So when I click smoothing, the whole thing does hit. I could go through and select each section and give it a surface name so I can actually edit the smoothing group separate, but I don't want that. I want all this to be the same surface. So what do I do about that? So we use a smoothing group. So what this does is you select the polygons and assign them to their own individual smoothing threshold here, so they can all be different types of threshold. So to show you what I mean, let's select a load of poly. So we'll select that row, we'll select the row below, so I'm just selecting three polys on the same axis and just looping it, and then I'm going to assign it. So make sure you're on set, and then I'm going to click it to one, and then you decide what smoothing group threshold you want. So let's just, I don't know, just put it about 50. So that's on its own group is number one. Okay, so if I just click in here and drop the selection, you can probably see that this is smooth now, everything else is not. So I can, good thing about this is if I drop the selection, if I select one, it tells you that one's assigned to one. I can click connected and it selects everything else connected to that smoothing group. Inverse, and it will select everything outside it that's on, that's currently on, which is quite cool. You can unassign it. Another thing is you can use these, so if I go on to, like, let's say the select option, just click on it, it will select all the polygons in that smoothing group. So you can also use them as groups of selections as well, which is quite cool. And again, the draw the IDs, that's just telling you that each one of these look number one in its place in the middle of the polygon or the normal, showing you that what it's assigned to, which I don't want on. You've got auto sign, you've also, you can attach the vertex normal map, and like I said, you can invert it and stuff. So that's one. Let's say I also wanted, let's say the bottom here, which I've gone and selected some of the actual ball as well, because it's quite, I've got it kind of overlapping a bit for some reason. So let's go to set, and this time I'm going to set it to 2 and decide how much of the threshold I want it to be, like so. So let's drop it. Let's just jump back to texture so you can see. So I've got this now smooth and this smooth and assigned to two different parts. And again, I can just select one, connect it all like so. Or I can go on to the select and just click it like that to select it. I'm just pressing forward slash to drop it. So I've got those two assigned as well. Another options, I don't know if you ever use this, like if I select one, let's just select this one poly. It's telling me here, look, it's attached to smoothing group 1. So if I press I on my keyboard, what this will bring up is the polygon information. So this is telling you everything about the polygon. But also, when I click the actual top bit of the polygon itself, it shows you the smoothing group. So you can reassign it to different smoothing groups, give it a different sketch colour for around the outside of it. So if I've changed it to kind of red for that one, so you'll get part of it, this part of it will be kind of red. I can give it a parts number. I can even assign a texture under it. So if I've got more than one, I could do it kind of more than one as well if I wanted to. In fact, if I just bring up this, you can see now, look, like that part is kind of red and stuff. But I could like select, oops, sorry, all of it. If I press I, it will bring up all the actual polygon information for each of them. So it might be that if I go and select all of them, which you can see here, you can reassign them here again, and the colours mix, so I could tell them to just be a different colour if I wanted to. And again, I could, all the ones that are selected, I can give a part number or a surface number or so on. And obviously I've changed them to green, so that selection, or shall I say that group of polygons that's assigned to this smoothing group, is obviously green, but it's not going to render like, you're not see them like that. But again, it's as simple as that. I mean, same with the actual ball. If we just go on to the ball itself, and every when you want a object on its own, it's got its own smoothing group. So the ball has its own smoothing group. So let's say, for instance, I wanted this area here to be set to 1, and I'll leave the threshold there. So if we just go here, you can see that middle bit there is nice and smooth. Let's go down here. Let's say that again to 2. So you can see that's smooth, that's smooth, that's not. Let's choose. This. Assign it to 3. Like so. So that's got the bits as well. That's got 3 bits as well. Okay. So let's just save that. Let's just send it through to layout. So we've got it here in layout. So we're thinking, oh, just a minute, that looks wrong. I've got my smoothing groups. Why is it not there? So we'll go into the surface edit and we'll click smoothing on. But it's all smooth. The reason being, the smoothing threshold needs to be at 0 or the lowest to 0. So if you press 0 in there, it's basically turning this off and using the smoothing group. So when you take it through, if you're thinking, why isn't it working? What you need to do is make sure you're on that texture, because they're all the same texture. The smoothing threshold down here is off, because then it removes it, leaving just the smoothing groups. As you can see on the ball here, these bits here are smooth. So if you're wondering, you take it through and it don't work and wondering how to do that, it's, you have to have this down to like 0.05. Just put 0 and it will go as low as you can. But you need to have smoothing on to see the smoothing groups. And again, that's how it will show up in here as well, looking your VPR and your render and stuff. But if you've got like car parts and complicated kind of cogs and everything, and you want different smoothing parts on, this is a good option. And I believe that you can actually take these, save these smoothing groups and take it through to your games engine as well. So that's the basics of smoothing groups. So what I'll do is, let me load up a seam. And from the desktop, where have I kept everything? Let's see. I don't know if this is it. I'm changing folders now. I don't want to do that. Okay, so yeah, just needed to switch contents folders. So here we've got my original kind of space deck that I was playing around with. And there is, I mean, I can put smoothing on, but I'm not really using kind of smoothing groups on this. So, but what I could do is, let's send it back to modeler, and you could do, so it could be that we start assigning smoothing groups. Or, tell a lie, have I already done this one? Yeah, so sorry, I've already done smoothing groups on this. So basically what I did, yeah, that's right, I've selected certain parts to show you bits that I've gone and added separately to show you how they've all got their own actual smoothing groups on. Just like you did with the parts, you would select the areas that, so with this one, it's telling me it's part of 2, look. And it might be that I want those to be part of it as well, so I can have all of them as the same smoothing group, and so on. So I could go round here. I mean, it will tell you if it's already part. You just need to click set again. So I'm assigning this to the right smoothing groups. But like I mentioned before, when you take it through and stuff, you need to just make sure that both the smoothing groups on for whatever, but zero in your main thresholds off, otherwise the smoothing groups won't show up. So for both these textures, can't remember which one I was using, you can see that certain smoothing groups are on for certain bits and others aren't because I haven't assigned them. But I mean, it could get a lot more complicated. So this kind of edge here around here with the smoothing groups off, you would see the polygons, the lines, and not the smooth edges and so on. But yeah, I mean, going back to the original shapes, it's a matter of just playing around and understanding it. I started off with basic shapes like this. The hardest part, believe it or not, the only part you get stuck on really is when you go through to layout, is not knowing to set this to zero, because I couldn't find that information anywhere. I just guessed, and it was a lucky guess that as soon as I figured it out, I was like, oh right, it's that easy. But it's really useful to have the smoothing groups on. So yeah, hopefully you've understood and you've learned a bit, and thanks for watching. Please subscribe and share. Check out my Lightwave Salvation Facebook group. Come and join us over there, and look out for my next tutorial.